Of pansies up from the cold.
Major! There's a girl in here!
Do you mean alive?
My name is Mary Lennox. Why has no one come for me? Where has everyone gone?
The cholera, miss. They're all dead, miss.
Mother! Father!
All dead, miss. I'm sorry, miss.
You have to leave that picture here, miss.
No, I will not. I'm taking it with me.
It's your pretty mother, is it?
No, it isn't.
Yes, well, come along.
Can it be a dream? Surely it must seem like a frightful dream. How can this be true? Won't her mother come? Wake her up to play, won't her father say, here's a rose for you. There's a girl who no one sees, there's a girl who's left alone, there's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known, for the life she's
Good evening, Major. I'm Mrs. Medlock, Dr. Craven's housekeeper. Is this the girl?
Yes, ma'am. Here are papers and the death certificates.
How is it, Major, that everyone in the house contracted the cholera?
Except Mary Lennox.
Could be, ma'am, because they never spent any time with the girl. Always throwing parties, they were.
Thank you, Major.
I spent 2 weeks with her now, and I think she's the most disagreeable child I've ever met. She's lucky we found this Uncle Archie, or I'd have been taking her to an orphanage.
Such a sour thing. I'd expected tears or complaints or fears. Seems she doesn't care what her life will bring, or is this the cost of the love she's lost? See how people stand. There's a girl who no one sees, there's a girl who's left alone, there's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known, for a feeling of a family, for the safety of a home. In a world that is rushing past her, there's a
would you like to know something about where you're going?
Not really.
But don't you care about your new home?
It doesn't matter whether I care or not.
Well, you're right not to care. Why you're being brought to Misselthwaite's, I never know. Your Uncle Archibald won't trouble himself about you. That's for sure and certain. He doesn't trouble himself about anyone. Your uncle's a hunchback, you see. And a sour young man he was, and got no good of all his money till he were married to your mother's sister, Lily. Did your mother tell you she had a sister?
My mother didn't tell me anything.
Well, her name was Lily. And she was a sweet, pretty thing. And he'd have walked the world over to get a blade of grass that she wanted. Nobody thought she'd marry him, but marry him she did. It weren't for his money either. Then she died.
How did she die?
Made him worse than ever. It's his brother, Dr. Craven, that makes all the decisions these days.
many does. It's only to wander the hallways and talk to ghosts.
All change! Pickering Station!
None of us can know where a girl must go, suffered such a blow. Pity her the pain. Now she stands so still, and she looks so cold, not a hand to hold. Pity she's so brave.
So ugly here.
Oh, that's the more it is. Miles and miles of wild land that nothing grows on but heather and gorse. And nothing lives on but wild ponies and sheep.
What is that awful howling sound?
Why, that's the wind blowing through the bushes. They call it wuthering, that sound. But look here. That'll be the gate, it will. That'll be Miss Ufwit. Mary Lennox, this is Dr. Craven, your uncle's brother.
You are to take her to her room. My brother doesn't want to see her.
Very good, Doctor.
A girl who doesn't cry, standing all alone, will she ever learn that others here are lonely? A girl who needs a home, looking up at me, I wonder if she knows if she's the girl who no one sees.
Well now, here you are then. This room the next to where you're with.
There's a girl who no one sees.
Well, you mustn't expect there to be people to talk to you. Your uncle won't have it.
Won't have it.
There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known. For a healing or a safety of a moon. For a moment is rushing past home.
These are not my clothes.
Aye, miss. Your uncle ordered them for you. The mountain. Now let's get these new clothes on and wrap you up warm so you can run out and play. Want to go out. I don't want to do anything.
Or maybe you'll run into my brother, Dickon out there.
Does he work here too?
If something is sick, he takes a look at it, sure he does. And he finds the ponies that run off and the eggs that roll out of the nest.
What's that?
Oh, that's the mortis. Like a dull purple sea this morning.
Do you like it?
I hate it. Well, of course you do. Because now it looks so big and bare. But in the spring, the moor's fair covered in heather and gauze, and there's such a lot of fresh air.
I don't care. And anyway, I don't like your brother Dickon.
Oh, well, I don't like him myself sometimes. But he's got a pony that wakes him up in the morning, and birds and sheep and such, he'd ride out of his hand.
Very well. Now that I'm dressed, you may take me out to meet your brother.
Oh, no, miss, I can't do that. I work inside and not outside.
You're my servant. You'll do as I say.
Oh, lass. If I had a fine white horse, I'd take it for a ride today. But since I have no fine white horse inside, I'll have to stay and empty all the chamber pots and screw up the floors and such. But from what I've heard of horses, we're not missing all that much. If I had a wooden boat, I'd take it for a sail today. But since I have no wooden boat inside, I'll have to stay and catch and kill the mice and pluck the chickens for the cook. But what can you do with a wooden boat? But sit up straight and look, and worry our boat will start to drift and float us out to sea and land us on an Isle of Gold. Oh dearie me. If I had a chambermaid, I'd take you out to play today. And up we didn't end up in a maze and lose our way. But just sit down and cry till Mrs. Medlock heard our moans. For we could starve to death by then and be just two piles of bones. For all I know, a band of elves are camped beneath the tree. And oh, those elves can bite, you know. Oh dear, oh dear. I'm afraid to take you out the door today. Talking birds and tales of spirits keep me scared away. I promised I would never tell what else is there, although if in a maze you chance to see a garden guarded by a tree and meet a bird who speaks of it, then come and tell my fine white horse and me.
Oh, there's Mrs. Medlock's bell. Right. If thou go that way, thou'll come to the garden. But be wary of Ben the gardener. He's none too friendly. Oh, and there's a garden that's locked up, so you'll stay away from that one as well.
Why would you lock up a garden?
Well, I must run. I forgot. I bought you a skipping rope.
Skipping rope?
Goodbye, Mary.
Bye.
Come along, love, come fly away. Fly along, come along, fly away.
Lots of hedge, cut it back.
Dig a hole, try and fill it. Lots of rows, tie it back. Find a mole, try and kill it. It's a maze, this guy, it's a maze of ways. Any man can spend his day. It's a maze, this guy, it's a maze of paths, but a soul can find the way. For an old man knows how a year it grows, how the cold in the spring comes around, how the seas take hold, how it burns up bold, how an English garden grows. Miss a step, trip and fall, miss a path, meet the wall, miss a way, miss a turn, getting lost is how you learn.
It's a maze of paths meant to lead a man astray. Turning left and then turning left again, how a soul can find a way.
But an old man knows how a year it goes, how the cold comes round, how the spring comes round, how the seas they go, how the birds unfold,
how an English garden grows. It's a maze, it's God, it's a maze of paths meant to lead a man astray. Turning left and then turning left again, how a soul can find a way. It's a maze, it's God, it's a maze, it's God, it's a maze, it's God. It's a maze, it's a maze, it's an English God.
It's a maze,
it's a maze, it's a maze, it's an English garden maze.
Prune this, weed that, trip all around.
Plant this, see that's how an English garden grows.
But our old man
missed that, dream all around,
on the seas that
are this, see that's how an English garden grows.
That was bloody awful. Do it again.
But an old man knows how a year it grows, how the cold dark cattle spring, how the seas take hold, how the birds unfold, how an English garden grows. How an English garden grows.
We've known this robin since he was a fledgling. He's always coming to see what I'm planting. Most of them can't abide human folk. But this one, he knew he was lonely.
Well, I'm lonely too. Why can't you speak to me?
How about that little wench from India?
What about that nasty gardener?
My name's Ben Webster. And it's no wonder that I'm lonely. I'm lonely myself. Except when he's with me. He's the only friend I've got.
I have no friends at all.
That'll mirror a good bit of that. We're neither of us good looking, and we're both as sour as we look.
I think I know where the robin lives. It's that locked up garden. Am I right?
That's the one, miss. That was Miss Lily's garden.
Was it the most beautiful place you've ever seen?
Ah, miss. It were. For being a secret place, they made things grow in there that wouldn't grow anywhere else on the moor.
Aren't you worried that Aunt Lily's garden will be dead with nobody taking care of it?
Of course I am. But if I so much as set foot in there...
Maybe the real reason the robin is chirping at you is because he wants you to climb over the garden wall and work on it.
Maybe it. But I can't go losing my job over there on the advice of some bird now, can I? And the same goes for you. If they catch you looking for that key, you could end up on the boat back to India. Or worse. Now run along and find Dickon. I've got work to do.
I haven't found Dickon yet, and I've been looking everywhere.
Girls ever to live in this valley. And 100 valleys of truth are told. Please excuse me.
But I want to know what happens to dead people.
Yes. Well, it's quite natural that you should want to that. We bury them. We put their things away. You remember the things they said. We talk to them. Sometimes.
Is my Aunt Lily a ghost now?
Why do you ask?
I heard someone crying in the house tonight. But I don't know anything about ghosts. Is my father a ghost now? Does everyone who dies become a ghost?
The only ghost of someone alive is still holding on to them.
I don't understand.
They're not gone, you see. Just dead.
Maybe what I heard was Mother telling me to be nice so you'll keep me.
This house is haunted, child. Day and night. I offer you my deepest sympathies on your arrival.
Did my mother have any other family?
Mary Alice, what are you doing out of bed?
I heard someone crying.
That was the wind.
That was not the wind.
That were the wind. And it should get a lot worse before it's through. Come on!
Oat cakes and cream, sweet plums in a jar.
Then every day to my garden, this man who might he be came bearing baskets of roses for he loved me.
All I own I'd give,
just a garden.
All I would ask is never to,
never to leave.
Say you'll have me,
see if you will keep me
where you. A girl I hardly knew, a girl who gave me a
you, Charles. Run along now.
I could, but what if I wasn't here and you wanted to tell him something else? Be much quicker if you learned to talk to him yourself.
But what could I say that he would understand?
Well, I wouldn't mention you're an egg-eater, if you know what I mean. But are you interested in flying, perhaps? Or bugs?
I'm afraid not.
Well then, you're just going to have to tell him that yourself. Now translate it into Yorkshire, till you get the way of it. Go on then.
I'm a girl.
She is a lass. Has took a greatly fancy to thee. Dost thou fear?
I may not fear.
She took thee on for like to vex thee. Now to the soul.
Now to the soul.
She knows her well, she moon not bright thee.
And it assure me.
Then better to know her.
Show me the key.
Show her the key.
Maybe he doesn't know. Have you ever been in that garden?
It's not mine to go into, Mary, but it might be yours. I can't say. He's been keeping it safe for somebody, that much I know.
He has?
Same way as the ivy grown over the door. But maybe the robin is waiting to hear why you want to go in there exactly. Well, you tell him.
Tell him?
Tell him why you want to go into the garden.
Do you think he'll listen?
He always listens if it comes from the heart.
I need a place where I can go, where I can whisper what I know, where I can whisper who I like, and where I go to see them. I need a place where I can hide, where no one sees my life inside, where I can make my plans and write them down so I can read them. A place where I can bid my heart be still and it will mind me. A place where I can go when I am lost and there I'll find me. I need a no one says to go or stay, where I can take my pen and draw the girl I mean to be. The girl I mean to be.
Well, he's singing back to you, isn't he?
I like him too. And I like Martha. And Ben. And you.
And the spring are coming. How would you like that, Mary?
I don't know anything about the spring. Are you sure it's coming?
Can't you smell it?
I smell something nice and fresh and damp.
That's the good rich earth, making ready to grow things. Winter's on a wing, soon a fine spring morns. Coming clean through the night comes the grey, I say. Winter's taking flight, sweeping dark cold air out to sea. Spring is born, comes the day, say I, and you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe. And feel it stop and lift high, rising fast on par, glaring down through the gloom. On the grey I say, the sun spells the doom of the winter's rain. Ice and chill must attack, on the may say hi, and you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe. And hear it, spring, I say. I say, be gone, ye howling gales, be off, ye frosty moans. Hold ye so the extremes begin to thaw. Melt ye waterfalls, part ye frozen winter walls. And now the mist is lifting high, leaving clear blue sky, rolling clear. Once more comes a mazy eye. The storm will soon be by, leaving clear blue sky. Soon the sun will shine, comes a mazy eye. And you'll be here to see it. Stand and breathe it all the day. Stoop and feel it. Stop.
Simply can just return to
Tarly the boy, Neville.
That. But what good does it do to sit by his bed, night after night, hoping for a miracle?
It happened and happened.
When Lily died, I gave him my practice, care.
And I've been completely faithful. I'm deeply grateful.
Then why waste your life waiting for its inevitable, tragic end?
I'm not wasting my life. This is my life now.
You sent for me, sir?
Yes, Charles. Come in. Are you well? Did they take good care of you?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
I'm sorry it's been so long since we've spoken. It's just I keep forgetting you. I intended to find you at school, so to all...
Oh, no, please don't send me away!
No. No, of course not. But is there anything you need? I thought maybe, like a governess, seeing as if you had the chance to look around now, and you know there's nothing for you to do here.
Oh, please don't make me have a governess, sir. There's everything for me to do here. There are so many gardens to walk around in, and so much to learn about them. Martha's teaching me to skip.
Play outside then, if you like. But is there anything you need? Maybe like some toys or dolls or books, perhaps.
Might I?
Yes. Speak up, child.
Might I have a bit of earth, sir? To plant seeds in. A garden.
Are you interested in gardens?
I didn't know about them in India. I was always tired and ill, and it was too hot. I used to play at making little flower beds, sticking things in the sand. But here, I might have a real garden. If you would allow it, sir.
Are you sure there's nothing else?
No, sir.
All right, then. You may have your earth. Take as much earth as you want.
Thank you very much, sir.
It's much nice being back this time. The dream's much more important. I hear things in the hallways. Voices and footsteps. It's the girl. She reminds you of Lily.
Lily?
I can see the resemblance myself. Although, Lily's hair was more gold. I think Mary's lonely, Neville. Perhaps it helps both if I had more conversations with her.
I don't think that is wise, Archie. It is my professional advice that you continue to obey your natural instincts and avoid
a bit of her. She wants a little bit of earth. She'll plant some seeds.
Now, if they may have your signature on these leases.
The seeds will grow. The flowers bloom, but is their bounty what she needs? How can she chance to love a little bit of earth? Does she not know? The earth is old and doesn't care if one small girl wants things to grow. She needs a friend. She needs a father, brother, sister, mother's arms. She needs to laugh. She needs to dance and learn to work her girlish charms. She needs a home. The only thing she really needs, I cannot give. Instead, she asks a bit of earth to make it live. She should have a pony gallop across the moor. She should have a doll's house with 100 rooms per floor. Why can't she ask for a treasure? Something that money can buy that won't die. When I'd give her the world, she asks instead for some earth. A bit of earth. She wants a little bit of earth. She'll plant some seeds. The seeds will grow. The flowers bloom, but is their beauty what she needs? She'll grow to love the tender roses, lilies fair, the iris tall. But then in time, a bit of earth will freeze and kill them all. A bit of earth. A bit of earth. A bit of earth.
Thank you.
Mrs. Medlock, I have my hands quite full with this storm, and I will thank you not to tell me what I must.
I'm sorry, sir. Sonny didn't mean to suggest that I...
Do what you can, Mrs. Medlock.
Martha will meet you outside. Look, you stay here in your room. They don't want you wandering about. Besides, what if it's a ghost crying?
I don't believe in ghosts. And even if I did, they don't cry. Boys and girls cry. Sick people cry.
I heard someone singing, who though could it be? Maybe it was Lily calling out to me. Maybe she's not gone so far away as I've been told. I heard someone singing, maybe it was she.
Maybe it was someone who is frightened here a lot like me. Maybe it was someone who is scared of lightning just like me.
Someone crying, though I can't say who. Someone in this house with nothing left to do. Sounded like a father all alone, his love grown cold. I heard someone crying, maybe it was you.
Maybe I was dreaming of a garden growing far below. Maybe I was dreaming of a life that I will never know.
Are you ever lost without you? I can't walk these walls without you.
Someone in this house,
I've searched the world to see.
Someone tell me what to hear except for me.
I heard someone sighing.
Maybe it was me.
My mother died too, when I was born. That's why my father hates me.
He hates the garden, too.
What garden?
Have you always been in this bed?
Sometimes I go to the seaside. But I don't like it. Because people stare at me. And one time, a daughter came from London and said to keep me out in the fresh air. But I hate fresh air.
If you don't want people to see you, do you want me to go away?
I want you to come back first thing tomorrow morning and tell me all about England.
Oh, I can't come tomorrow morning. I have to go and look for something with Dickon.
Who's Dickon?
He's Michael's brother. He's my friend.
If you go outside with that Dickon boy, is he ever coming here to talk to me? I'll send him away.
You can't send Dickon away.
I can do whatever I want. If I overlive, this entire place will belong to me.
You little Raja, if you send Dickon away, I'll never come into this room again.
I'll make you. They'll drag you in here.
I won't even look at you. I'll stare at the floor.
You are really selfish.
You're more selfish than I am. You're the most selfish boy I ever saw.
I'm selfish because I'm dying.
Just say that to make people feel sorry for you. If you were a nice boy, it might be true. But you're too nasty to die.
No. Please don't go. The storm scares me. If I went to sleep, I know I'd have such terrible dreams.
I have terrible dreams too.
They're not all terrible. It's just that some nights I dream that a round-shouldered man comes in my room on a beam of moonlight. He never says what he wants. He just sits with a book in his hands. And then I dream that the round-shouldered man takes me off on a ride through the moors by moonlight. He never says where we go. We just ride across the hills till dawn. And some night I'm going to ask him, is the night sky blue?
Thank you. Archie, you must do something about Mary. Last night, she stole into Colin's room and caused such a disturbance, I had to sedate the boy to get him to sleep. Any more visits like this, and we'll put him into hospital.
We will not put him into hospital, Neville. Lily would never forgive me.
Then you must send Mary away, before she undoes everything we've worked so hard to
do. I can't send her away. She has no one in the world but me. Can't you take her outside? She likes the gardens, I believe.
Then you take her to the gardens. You take on the responsibility of supervising her. Where are you going?
I'm leaving, Neville. I'm useless here. I can't do anything for Colin. Last night, I dreamed I was in Lily's garden. And I saw Mary standing there. Mary. Standing right there in Lily's garden. I turned away. I couldn't watch. I was afraid. Now, I'll go and check on Colin.
Archie, be sure not to wake him.
In 10 years have I ever disturbed him?
I promise you, Archie, as soon as he is well enough, you may speak with him as much as you like.
Have the carriage brought round. I'd like a word with Ben if you can find him.
Shall I gather the staff so you can say goodbye?
For God's sake, Neville! Just let me slip away. Sorry. Tell them whatever you always tell them.
Strangely quiet, I feel the storm simply rest to strike again. Something stirs me to think of how casts a spell. All night we hear her sighs, and now a girl has come who has her eyes. She has her eyes. The girl has Lily's hazel eyes, those eyes that saw him happy long ago, those eyes that gave him life and hope he'd never know. How can he see this girl and miss her pain?
She has eyes. Girl has Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes closed and left me all alone. Those eyes I feel will never, ever let me go. How can I see this girl and miss those hazel? This house seemed to be, and I, her bravest knight, became my lady fair was she.
She has her eyes, she has my Lily's hazel eyes, those eyes that love my brother, never me. Those eyes that never saw me, never knew I longed to hold it close, to live at last in Lily's
eyes. Imagine me a lover.
I longed for the day she'd turn and see me standing there.
Would God have let her stay?
Those eyes are closed and left me all alone.
say goodbye. Now, let's see. When we left off last night, the hideous dragon had carried the maid to his cave by moonlight. He gnashed his teeth, breathed his fire. The earth trembled and quaked in fear. Now, I said, someone must save the sweet raven-haired maiden, though surely the cause will be dear. So we lads hold your lots, our insides tied in knots, and I walked, and the rest disappeared. So I picked up my staff and I followed the trail of the sunk to the mouth of the cave, and I bade him come out. If sooth I did shout, youthful dragon, be gone or behave. And then under my breath, I uttered a charm said to make the worst fiend become kind. Knaves and knights of dire plights now diminish the sights. And I won, the dragon went blind. And he charged off the cliff, howling mad, and he died. Then the maiden accepted my ring. And a son came along, who was brave, bold, and strong. And in thanks, every night now I sing. Race you to the top of the morning. Come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you. Climb hills to remind you. I love you, my boy, at my side. Now another foul dragon's appeared, I must leave you. He's scorching our land with his breath. From this lair, this one taunts me, he dares me, he haunts me. Once again, we must fight to the death. Would to God I could stay and instead slay your dragon, this beast who since hunched on your back. Would to God I could wrench him away from your bed, or cut off or tear off his terrible head. Could breathe out my fire on him till he was dead, and beg him to spare you and take me instead. I must leave you in care of my brother, the wizard who lives on the hill, who has promised his art will soon pierce through the heart of this dragon that's keeping you ill. And I know that your mother, God bless her, would want you to do as she says and grow strong. And you know that as soon as I can, I'll return. So be brave, son. And know that I long to race you to the top of the morning. Come sit on my shoulders and ride. Run and hide, I'll come and find you. Climb hills to remind you. My boy and my son.
Sending her away.
I'm only giving her the education she deserves. It's all right then.
Find your sources. And then?
keep an eye on Mary when she's in the gardens.
I will, sir. Have a safe journey, sir.
Promises a secret streak of green inside it, and through the darkest night.
waiting for the right time when a thing is with.
It will grow.
Coming back, weren't you?
Maybe.
I'll leave you to alone, Matthew.
You thought I'd forgotten.
I thought you weren't coming back.
I was always coming back, Colin. It just took me longer than I thought because...
Because what?
You promised not to tell if I tell you.
I promise.
I found your mother's garden.
Do you mean a secret garden?
It's been locked up out there. Just like you've been locked up in here for 10 years. Only I found the key. And the other night, after Dr. Craven and Mrs. Medlock found us in here together, I ran out into the storm and found the door. Dickens says, if we clear away all the dead wood, there'll be fountains of roses by summer.
I didn't know my mother had a garden.
You must see it. But Dr. Craven and Mrs. Medlock must never know I've taken you out there. Or they'll send me away. I'll just go and get your wheelchair.
No. Mary, I can't go. I'll catch a chill. I'll get even worse.
No, you won't. You'll feel so much better.
No.
I'll be right back.
Mary.
Thank you.
passing the leaves is no business of mine.
Well, then have you seen Dickon?
How am I absent? What do you want with them?
None of your business, Bellwether Staff.
Dickon's a grand lad, and you'll be a fool if you send him away.
I'm not sending anyone away. That'll be up to Dr. Craven.
It's my mother's garden. It is.
It's a secret garden. And we're the only ones in the world that wanted to be alive. Dickon!
You? And Martha too?
Martha, you surprised to see me outside?
But that I am, Master Colin. But just now, you look so much like your mother. It fair made my heart jump. Dickon, this is my cousin, Colin Craven. Colin, this is my friend Dickon.
I'm very pleased to meet you, Dickon. You may push me now. Martha, I don't like fresh air when I'm by myself. But when Mary's with me, I do.
Still, Colin, you must remember.
I don't want to remember. When I lie by myself and remember, I begin to have pains and think of things that make me begin to scream. Isn't that right, Mary?
You must take in long breaths of fresh air, Colin. That's what Dickon does when he's lying on the moor.
Makes me feel strong, it does. Makes me feel like I could live forever and ever.
Forever and ever.
And it makes you hungry, too. I never wanted my breakfast when I was in India, but now I always want it.
Martha, look at me. I'm breathing long breaths of fresh air.
Oh, I wish your mother could see this.
I want to come to the garden every day. I want to live forever and ever.
You could meet the robin that showed me this garden. You could help us plant and weed.
Could we, Martha?
You could if it were a secret. I could bring you food out here of Davidel. Things my mother makes. All cakes and ham. But you better be getting inside now, before they begin to suspect you're up to something.
Dickon, you should have seen Colin in the house this morning. Dr. Craven told Colin he was gaining weight and his colour was better.
I'm starting to feel rather sorry for Dr. Craven.
So am I. He won't get mistletoe at all now that I'm going to die.
Yes, but it must have been horrid to be polite for 10 years to a boy who was always rude.
Am I rude?
It's always having your own way that's made you rude. But I was that way too, before I found the garden.
What is it about this garden? When I'm here, I feel so much better, so much stronger.
Maybe there's some healing power in the air.
In India, we use charms to make people better.
Charms?
Yes, like this.
door.
You got out here.
I am not crippled.
Then what have you been doing? Never coming out to the house and letting Thorpe think you were a cripple.
Master. Mary Lennox, Colin! What's going on here? Don't blame them. I made them bring me out here.
But they should have known better. And they will be punished for this. You can be sure of it. You were a very sick child, and every day you managed to live is precious. Think of all what Dr. Craven has done for you. And here you are. In the very garden where his mother died. Mary Lennox, headmistress of your new school, is waiting for you in the library. Martha, get Colin back in that house this once. And Ben! Well, I don't know what's to be done with you. But I can imagine the packing would be appropriate.
Mrs. Medlock, you have my permission to withdraw.
5 minutes. All right, then, in we go.
Not yet, Martha. I have something to ask Ben. And don't you dare say a word about this.
I'm your servant, young Master Colin. As long as I live.
Did you know my mother?
That I did. I was her right hand round these gardens.
I want to know.
She said to me once, Ben, if I'm ever ill, or if I go away, you must take care of me roses.
But I thought my mother died when I was born. But just now, Mrs. Medlock.
That's right, lad. She fell as how it happened. She was sitting on a branch, right there when it broke. But she started her labouring with you. But the fall had badly hurt her back. Still, she clung on to life till you were born. She put you in your father's arms. She died.
So that's why he hates me.
It weren't your fault, lad.
It really wasn't my fault then?
No, lad. Of course not.
Come in.
There's Mrs. Winthrop for you, sir.
Excellent. Please send her in.
Yes, sir.
Sir, Mrs. Winthrop, I trust you had a pleasant journey down from Aberdeen.
Actually, no, Doctor. I've always found the English countryside to be quite tiresome.
Yes. Well, please sit down. I have completed the forms you have sent us. And I'm sure you will see that my brother has included a contribution to the school's bill. I'm sure you're in the planning process of something or another.
You cannot imagine
what... What brings you into the middle of a private conversation? Have you quite lost your mind?
Oh, forgive me, sir. I brought you young Mary as you requested.
Yes. Well, Mary, this is Mrs. Wilson of the Aberdeen School for Girls.
Good morning, Mary. I don't want to go to a school.
Oh, but you do. There's so much for you to learn.
My Uncle Archibald said...
Just
Well, think nothing of it.
Of course, Doctor. Perhaps you'd enjoy seeing some samples of the girls at their work. I have several samples of the fine lace of which our girls are so...
I hate you! You're a horrible, ugly pig!
That's quite enough now, young lady.
Your school is a filthy rat hole full of nasty girls and dirty beds, and all anybody really does there is scrub floors. I hope you get hit by a train on your way home, and your ugly head rolls off into a ditch and gets eaten by maggots!
Well, never would I do kiss to this severity!
I hate you, and if I have to go off with you, I'm going to bite your arm, you're going to die!
Doctor, what you have here is a psychiatric problem!
I'm going outside!
You're going wherever I send you, young lady. And by this one, it's to that chair.
My ambulance
will serve. For God's sake! He doesn't care about you! He never wants to see you again! Why do you think he left without even saying goodbye to you?
Maybe he was in a hurry.
You drove him away. You're a mind mother's wife.
I look like my Aunt Lily.
You're bound to be packed, and you will leave Saturday week.
But I can't leave now. Colin needs me.
The last thing the boy needs is you. You have no idea how sick he is.
Well, you haven't seen how much better he is.
Do you want him? Do you want him to die? Don't you understand? He could die.
Die?
You must go, and go you will. That's all I have to say on that.
I didn't do anything. You locked him in his room. You don't want Colin to get better at all. You just want him to die so you can have this house.
He will leave Saturday week.
Buy you those books and send you those clothes? Well, didn't he?
But Colin's going to die! And it's all my fault!
I think you were just what Colin needed.
But you're not a doctor, Martha. Will you tell him I didn't mean to hurt him?
You're talking like you've already gone, Mary.
I am gone, Martha. I wish I were a ghost.
Say, is this day not me? A spell to go away. Child, hold on. Is this day not you that's bound to go away? You then is remember this old thing you heard me say. Is the storm you know is true, hold on till you get through, child, oh child, hold on. Oh, when you feel your heart is pounding, though the devil at your door, there's no place to hide, you're frozen to the floor. What you do then is you force yourself to wake up and you say, is this dream not me that's bound to go away? Hold on, hold on, the night will soon be by. Hold on, don't even ask how long or why. Child, hold on, there's angels on their way. Hold on and hear them say, child.
just come flying at you from across the room. When you see a man who's raging and he's jealous and he feels that you've walked through walls he's hid behind for years, what you do then is you tell yourself to wait it out and say, is this day not me that's bound to go away? Child, hold on, is this day not you that's bound to go away?
Should take a pen and paper and write to your uncle in Paris. I think Colin's father should be the one to decide whether Colin should be allowed out or not.
But why would he listen to me? And what if the letter didn't get to him in time? Dr. Craven said I'm leaving Saturday week.
I'm sure your uncle will send for you as soon as he sees what you've done. Right, here's a pen and here's some paper. I do hope you know how to write, because I won't be much help to you in that department.
A little.
D-E-A-R.
Uncle Archie, how are you? I'm fine. Everybody else is too. Please come home.
Home? I have no home.
Martha says that you're in Paris.
It's a house, Charles.
Is that very far away?
Just a house.
Do they have nice girls and boys there?
And I can't get far enough away from it.
Please come home. Should I say that Colin's well now?
Streets of Paris, like a maze.
Should I say that Dr. Craven?
Sleepless nights and endless days.
I think that what you have is good. Let's get it posted on its way. He'll rush home and you can tell him all the rest you have to say. Oh, kind sir,
can't forgive
Archie, how
can't
I wish that
sleep,
you could
or live.
See when you come into the garden. Please come.
Can't
home.
Forgive.
Yours truly.
Well,
I see you in the window of a carriage, then a train. Still my mind will not accept it. In your grave you must remain. Now I hear your voice. I turn to see a stranger's form and face. Must I wander on, tormented, place to place, to place to place? Where can I go that you won't find me? Why can't I find a place to hide? Why do you have to chase me, haunt me? Every step you're there beside me. Where in the world, tell me where in the world can I live without your love? Why on the earth, tell me why on the earth can I stay now that you are gone? Why did I have to meet you, love you? Why can't I rid you from my mind? Why do you have to watch me? Won't you let me put my life behind me? How in the earth, tell me how in the earth can I live without your love? How on the world, tell me how on the earth can I stay now that you are gone? Now that you are... Lily? Is that you?
Could I ever know?
can bear not to dream.
What about me?
How can I let you go?
Now you must let me go.
All I need
is there in the garden.
All I would ask
is care for the child of our love. Come go with me, safe I'll keep you.
Where you would lead me, there I would.
There I would, there we would.
There we will go.
Father. I'm well.
Oh, Colin. Colin, my fine, brave boy. Neville, were you able to surprise me with this good news?
Well, of...
Of course I knew they were looking better. I had no idea.
We didn't want you to know. We were afraid you wouldn't let us come to the garden if you knew.
But... how is it that you look so healthy?
Mark brought us food, and we ate in the garden.
Garden?
Oat cakes, and roasted eggs, and fresh milk.
It's all terribly confusing. I'm sure it is confusing, Neville.
Why don't you take my flat in Paris?
Say that as long as you like. And when you're turn, let me help you to re-establish your practice in town.
Thank you, Archie.
Colin, look at you.
It was Ben that kept the garden alive, Father. Until we could get here.
Ben?
No, it was against our orders.
As far as I can remember, Ben, it was Lily who wanted you to take care of the cards. Well done.
Thank you, sir.
And it was Dickon as well.
Yes, I can imagine. Dickon.
Hi, sir.
So if there's ever anything, just ask.
Thank you, sir.
But, sir, what's to become of our Mary?
Mary?
Here's your key, if you want it back,
sir. I nearly forgot something.
Hard to remember everybody.
Yes, it is. Three isn't very many people at all. I should be able to remember three people quite easily.
Would I be one of them?
Mary, let us. For as long as you will have us, we are yours, Colin and Darwin. And this is your home. And this, my lovely child, is your garden.